Hey everyone, Sam from Professional Music Technology here, and today we're talking about home studio monitors. Now, there's a few factors that you need to consider when you're choosing a pair of monitors for your studio. For example, how much space you've got, the type of music that you're producing, what volume you're realistically going to be listening at, and of course, how much you've got to spend. So with all of that in mind, we've picked out seven of our favourite mid-level near-field monitor speakers, which we feel should give you options to cover all of these bases. They're all active, meaning there's no need for an external amplifier, and they all offer excellent sound reproduction while still remaining reasonably affordable. So here's our top recommendations for some of the best home studio monitors that you can get for under £500 a pair. So first up on our list of best home studio monitors is the Yamaha HS7 Matched Pair. Now, Yamaha near-field reference monitors with their iconic white woofers have kind of been an industry standard in studios around the world since the 1970s, renowned for their honest, accurate sound reproduction. And the HS range maintains this legacy while still remaining affordable enough for most home studios. Featuring a 6.5-inch cone woofer and a 1-inch dome tweeter, the HS7s are one of the larger monitors on our list today. And as they feature a rear-ported cabinet design, they ideally need to be positioned with a bit of space behind them, so they may not be overly suitable for a cramped home studio. But because of that larger speaker and a total bi-amped output of 95 watts per cabinet, that's 60 watts for the low frequencies and 35 watts for the highs, they offer a pretty serious punch in terms of volume, whilst maintaining an accurate balance across the frequency spectrum. And when you buy the HS7s as a match pair, each monitor has been acoustically matched to ensure the most precise performance possible. Looking at the rest of the specs, Yamaha's newly developed transducers ensure an incredibly smooth response over a large frequency range, going from 43 Hz at the low end, whilst the high frequency tweeter will remain distortion free right up to 30 kHz. There's EQ trim switches allowing you to tailor the response of the HS7s to the room that you're mixing in. Plus, they offer a choice of balanced XLR or TRS jack inputs to connect to your interface or mixer. So if you're after a pair of pro quality, flat response reference monitors that won't falsely flatter your mix like some other speakers do, definitely check out the Yamaha HS7s, or depending on the kind of space that you've got available in your studio, there's either the larger HS8s or the smaller HS5s. The next pair of monitors we're looking at are the most affordable option on our list, and that's the Presonus Eris E5s. But despite their lower price tag, these monitors still sound great, delivering a smooth, accurate frequency response. They offer a wide range of features and options, and because of their compact size and front-ported design, they're perfect for even the smallest of home studios. So looking at the tech specs, the E5s feature a 5.25-inch woven composite low-frequency driver and a 1-inch silk dome tweeter, which when combined offers a frequency response range of 53 Hz up to 22 kHz. Considering their smaller size, the Class AB bi-amplification system is surprisingly powerful, kicking out a total of 80 watts per monitor, with a high headroom to remain distortion-free at higher volumes. As I mentioned a moment ago, the bass port is on the front of the cabinet, so they can be positioned right up against the wall without the bass frequency reproduction being affected. And because the monitors are RF shielded, they can be placed really close to a computer screen without any interference. So as you can see, they're ideal if space is tight. Versatile connection options include balanced XLR and jack inputs, as well as RCA phono sockets for connecting to a DJ style mixer. And a selection of EQ controls allow you to adjust the response of the monitors to suit your room and speaker positioning, whilst a low cut switch is handy for if you also want to run a subwoofer, like a lot of dance and hip hop producers do. So if you are looking for a more affordable option to suit a small home studio, the Presonus Eris E5s are one of the best sounding near field monitors in their price range, which at just under £200 is pretty much half the price of some of the other models that we're looking at today. Definitely worth checking out. So our next pick on our rundown of best home studio monitors is the KRK Rokit RP5, which has been one of our best-selling near-field monitors for quite a while now. But this is the latest G4 version, which features some pretty substantial upgrades over the previous models. Just like the earlier incarnations of the RP5, the G4 features a 5-inch low-frequency woofer with a high-frequency tweeter. But now both of these drivers are made from matching Kevlar, ensuring the same sonic integrity across all frequencies, and this offers clearer sound reproduction and helps to minimise listening fatigue. The cabinet and front baseport have also been re-engineered to offer more low-end accuracy and more flexible speaker positioning options. But the biggest upgrade to the Rokit range is its onboard DSP-driven graphic EQ. With 25 settings, all displayed on a backlit screen, this really sets the Rokits apart from any other monitor that we're looking at today, allowing you a huge range of options to precisely tune the speakers to any acoustic environment, making the KRK G4s probably the most versatile studio monitors in their class. In terms of the other specs, the RP5s offer a frequency response range of 43Hz to 40kHz. The high quality bi-amped Class D amplifiers deliver a total of 55 watts per monitor, driving the speakers evenly to improve audio integrity and more efficiently to reduce operating temperatures. And finally, input connections come courtesy of a pro quality Neutric balanced XLR jack combi socket. So as you can see, with the fourth generation Rokits, KRK have made some pretty significant improvements to what was already a fantastic range of studio monitors. We've been looking at the RP5s as they're probably the best suited to a smaller home studio. But if you do need more power and an extended frequency response, they're also available in larger 7, 8 and 10 inch models. And of course, you can take a listen and compare the whole range at your nearest PMT store. Now, as I mentioned previously, the KRK Rokit RP5s were one of the most popular home studio monitors long before the arrival of the G4 models. And there is kind of an argument to say, if it wasn't broke, then why fix it? And that's where the next monitors on our list come in. That's the KRK Classic 5s. Based on the much-loved third generation Rokit RP5s, these monitors feature the classic curvy KRK front-ported cabinet design, and a more back-to-basics approach to tuning when compared to the DSP EQ of the latest version of the Rokits. Now, if you've owned a pair of G3 RP5s, you're probably already familiar with a lot of the features of the Classic 5s, but if not, let's just run through the highlights. In terms of drivers, the KRK Classics feature a 5-inch glass aramid composite woofer handling frequencies down to 43Hz, and a soft dome tweeter with an optimised waveguide provides smooth, pristine and articulate highs up to 35kHz. And these are powered by custom bi-amped Class AB amplifiers, offering loads of headroom and low distortion. To improve clarity, factory installed under monitor foam pads provide isolation between the speakers and the surface that they're placed on, and built-in limiters prevent any unexpected peaks from damaging the speakers if you get a little bit over enthusiastic with those volume knobs. Now, one criticism that some people had of older KRK Rokits is that they used to kind of flatter the sound a little. So your mix would sound great when you played it through the speakers themselves, but it wouldn't necessarily have the same kind of punch and sparkle when heard on other systems. So for this reason, along with the optional high and low frequency boost modes, the Classic 5s now feature options for a flat response, allowing for more critical listening, which should help you produce more accurate mixes. And to cater for a wide variety of input sources, there's a choice of RCA Phono, Balanced XLR or TRS jack connections. So if you want the sound quality and the features of the best-selling KRK RP5s, but maybe you're not all that fussed about the digital processing that they've introduced on the latest models, the Classic 5s are probably the one for you. And even better, you're going to save yourself a few quid in the process. So moving on, next up we're looking at the smallest, most compact monitors on our list, and that's the Adam A3Xs. But don't be fooled by their size, they still share the same pro quality sound reproduction and features as the larger models in Adam's widely acclaimed AX range. Perfectly suited for small home studios or mobile recording setups, each Adam A3X can deliver 50 watts RMS with a frequency response of 60 Hz to 50 kHz. Low frequencies are handled by a 4.5 inch carbon fiber woofer, which offers excellent transient response even at high sound levels without any breakup of the diaphragm, whilst the high frequencies are reproduced in crystal clear clarity via Adam's innovative X-Art tweeter. With a 2.5 times larger surface area than a conventional dome tweeter, this allows for a more advanced dynamic range in the high frequencies. Plus, its folded ribbon design means that the distortion is kept to an absolute minimum, meaning that you can mix on these monitors for much longer periods of time without developing any hearing fatigue. The geometry of the cabinets has been acoustically optimized to reduce any unwanted sound reflections from the cabinet itself. They're front ported for accurate bass reproduction and to offer more speaker positioning options. And one feature that we really like is that the volume controls are actually on the front of the monitors, so you don't need to keep reaching around to the back panel to make any adjustments. Speaking of the rear panel though, there's balanced and unbalanced input options, a control to adjust the volume of the high frequency tweeter, and one final handy feature is a stereo link where one monitor becomes the master and the other the slave, allowing you to adjust the level of both via the one volume control. So if space in your studio is a bit of an issue, but you still need a really high quality pair of monitors, definitely go and check out the Adam A3s. Or if you do have a larger studio space and can maybe budget for more than £500 a pair, the larger A5s, A7s and A8s are also fantastic options for any home studio. If you do like the look of the larger Adam A-series monitors, but maybe they're a little out of your budget, there is a more affordable option, and that's the Adam T-series, which borrows quite a few of its design features from its bigger brothers, but has a substantially lower price tag. Today, we're looking at the T5Vs, which feature 5-inch drivers, but there is also a larger 7-inch model, the T7V, which offers a slightly wider frequency response range, but is a larger unit. Those woofers are constructed from lightweight polypropylene, meaning that even at higher volumes, you'll still get great transient response without the diaphragm starting to distort. And they're accompanied by a 1.9 inch UART or accelerated ribbon tweeter, based on the tweeters found on the A3X that we looked at a moment ago. And just like those tweeters, their folded design and larger surface area really opens up the high frequency dynamic range right up to 25 kHz. And allows for extended mixing sessions before your ears start to get fatigued. The tweeters are then fitted to a waveguide, which shares the exact same dispersion control attributes as the HPS waveguide found on Adam's flagship S-series monitors. But whereas those are made from aluminium, the T-series waveguides have been moulded from plastic to keep the cost down. This clever design disperses the high-end frequencies nice and evenly, keeps stereo imaging consistent and helps to reduce early reflections off of the surfaces in your studio, such as your desk or mixing console. The cabinets themselves are rear ported and tuned to deliver a tight bass response with very low compression. And just like the more expensive AX range speakers, the cabinet's geometry has been acoustically optimized, reducing any unwanted reflections from the actual cabinets themselves. The rear panel features connections for both balanced XLR or unbalanced phono inputs, and quite usefully, these inputs are switchable, meaning you can actually have two separate sources permanently connected at the same time, which can easily be switched between without unplugging anything. And finally, high and low frequency attenuator switches offer either a 2 dB boost or reduction, allowing you to tweak the bass or treble of the monitors depending on your speaker positioning or the acoustics of your room. So that's the Adam T5Vs, a great budget-friendly option for your home studio. And I think I forgot to mention when I was talking about the A3Xs, but it's also worth bearing in mind that when you buy any pair of Adam monitors, you can register them on the Adam website and get a 5-year warranty, making them even better value. So our final recommendation on our list of best home studio monitors comes from RCF, world-renowned for their PA speakers, but who also manufacture some really high-quality studio monitors. And these ones, the Ayra Pro 6s, are one of their more affordable offerings. Physically, the Ayra Pro is one of the larger monitors that we've looked at today, featuring a 6.5-inch woofer, but this does mean that it has an extended low frequency response range, right down to 45 Hz. And these are the most powerful monitors on our list, with their Class D low distortion amplifiers kicking out a total of 120 watts per monitor. So that's 80 watts for the woofer and 40 for the tweeter, all protected by internal limiters to stop any clipping. To handle that power, the woofers are made from a high quality composite fiberglass, and the high frequencies, up to 20 kHz, are handled by a 1-inch ferrofluid cooled soft dome tweeter, fitted to an RCF precision waveguide to help disperse those treble frequencies accurately. Clever onboard DSP optimizes frequency and dynamic response, and a first for a studio monitor in this class, the Ayra Pro 6 offers 0° phase response thanks to its fur phase technology, ensuring a transparent sound, absolute clarity, and a perfect stereo image. The cabinets themselves feature low distortion front vented bass ports, and the rear panel has a choice of unbalanced RCA phono, balance jack, or XLR connections, plus trim switches to boost or cut the high and low frequencies to suit your room. So if you've got a bit of space to play with in your home studio and you're looking for a pair of powerful, great sounding monitors that come in at a very reasonable price, then definitely go and take a listen to the RCF Ayra Pro 6s. So thanks for watching. That was 7 of our top recommendations for if you need a pair of home studio speakers for under £500. Now, obviously, there's no kind of demo that we can really do here that will do any of these any justice, but you can go and take a listen for yourself to any of the monitors that you've seen here today at your nearest professional music technology store. As usual, for more information, visit pmtonline.co.uk, and don't forget to follow us on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram as PMT House of Rock. And if you enjoyed this video and found it helpful, please do give it a thumbs up, hit that subscribe button, ring the notifications bell so you never miss a video, and I'll see you again soon.